Hi everyone, it's Joni Young here. Welcome back to my channel. Today I'm going to be showing you how to paint this pretty forest landscape using gold, white, orange, yellow, light blue, and black. We're starting on an 11 by 14 double primed canvas, and I'm going to squeeze out some black, white. You can use any black or white that you want using my gold metallic paint. I've got a large flat brush. I'm gonna get it wet and take gold, and I'm gonna start spreading all that paint around in diagonal lines for sun rays and the beginning of the composition for all of our trees, because this is the angle that they're all gonna be going on. Now, what you're not seeing is that I am picking up a little bit of water here and there to help spread the paint around. Okay, so the next thing I'm doing is just removing some of this paint off. My brush is wet, so I'm able to just scumble off some of that gold paint, and I'm pulling lines, sliding my brush back and forth diagonally to lay in some of the trees and where I'm going to begin coming in with some black. So I'm going to do this all the way around to the other side. Now, if you need to, you can wipe the excess paint off on a towel nearby and then get a little bit of water on your brush if you're not able to cut in all these lines and edges. I'm working wet on wet. I'm keeping my studio a little bit cool so I'm able to keep the paint nice and wet so I can keep working with it. Now I'm picking up a little bit of black with the gold, and I'm going to start coming in with my trees. They're going to be slightly larger, wider at the base or at the edge of the canvas. And then as they go up towards the sky, they're going to get narrower. This gives us that perspective and feeling like we're kind of looking up to the sky, looking up towards the tops of those trees. Maybe picture yourself laying down on a blanket in the forest. So yeah, it'll be that kind of composition and look to it. It's a really, really dramatic way to paint, and I really love painting in this style. So I'm going to keep coming in with black, and I'm going to do different sizes. Some are going to be a lot larger than others, and some of them are going to be a lot skinnier and a little bit more faded too, to make it look like they're further away off in the distance, or maybe the light from that sun that we're going to add is going to be casting some sun rays down, making those tree trunks look a lot lighter. So I recommend using a flat brush like this to get nice straight edges. And you don't have to have perfectly straight edges, guys. But for this specific landscape and painting today, I wanted to have straight trees and leave out all those flowy curves that I usually like to add to my trees. taking both those colors again, and I'm going to start tapping in the foreground. So maybe there's some moss, ferns, some ground cover, and just tapping, pulling, lots of little shapes and little ridges and bumps. We just need to have something down here for a base, and then we'll build up on it a little bit by using a mop brush and a fan brush and a filbert brush. Now you notice the branches that I added and the little trees on the top corners of the painting are a little bit wavier and curvier because those are different types of trees and I wanted to have it a little bit softer and flowier that up in the corners there I decided partway through. You can keep yours straight if you want, or you can make them a little bit wavy like mine. So I'm going to define these tree trunks some more. And then I'm going to come in with a different brush and start adding a few branches and leaves and some branches on those trees to start filling them in a little bit more. If you're really looking for a deep, deep black for some extra contrast and making your painting a little bit more dramatic, I would recommend not using this thinner black paint. This is just a craft paint I'm using today, but if you want a really good deep black, Mars Black is a nice one to use. It'll dry really dark, whereas this will dry just a little bit softer, but that was kind of the look that I kind of personally wanted to go with this painting. So you can see I've got my mop brush now, and I'm gonna tap in to the black. You only want the end of this brush wet with paint, and I did not get it wet beforehand. I never put my mop brush in the water unless I'm gonna use it for dripping off of the top of the canvas. In this case, I'm not. I'm just tapping in foliage and getting a different texture and look going at the bottom and the base of these trees. And I'm gonna carry this brush and this technique up into the trees and do the same thing, lightly tapping. In some areas, I'm going to make the black in the branches a little bit more solid, and in others, I just want to have a little bit of a see-through effect going on because I'm going to layer over with some orange and yellow a little bit later on, and I want to have those colors peeking through, and I'm going to also put it over top of the black. It'll make the black a warmer tone and a little bit softer on the eyes, easier on the eyes, and just in general warm up this painting and soften it up a little bit more. So I'm taking a little bit of gold as well, and I'm going to tap that in. So what the gold does is gives you that nice color, but it also gives you a really interesting metallic sheen. So wherever the light is coming from and hitting your painting, you're going to get an extra glow, and it kind of just brings your painting to life. It's a really fun paint to use. I've got a few more videos of painting forests and other landscapes using gold metallic paint. I'll leave links in the description below for you guys for those, okay? Now I'm going to keep tapping wherever I want to have some little bushes and trees, but I'm not going to do too much because I don't want to lose all those tree trunks and that neat effect that we've got going on. Okay, I'm going to switch over to my liner brush, and I'm not showing you this, but I am washing my brushes in between. It's really important, you guys, because the acrylic will ruin your brushes if it's left in them too long. I'm taking water on my paint and black, a little bit of gold, mixing the two, and I'm going to pull from the tree trunk and wiggle, barely touching the canvas, kind of twirling and rolling that brush in between my fingers. So have a look at where the brush where exactly I'm holding it and what I'm doing with my thumb and my finger, because that is key in getting your branches down and making it so much easier. And if you're a little bit shaky and nervous, I always tell my students that'll make better branches because you want them to be kind of shaky and crooked looking. Okay, so I'm just going to add a few little ones here off to the left. Again, picking up a little bit of gold. Sometimes I'm just going to use straight black, and then other times I'm softening it with a little bit of that gold. And I'm going to do the same thing here and there, a few more trees, and then we'll move on to the next step. So you have your paint is not flowing easily out of your brush. Sometimes you can go back for more paint, but you may also need to have a little bit of water in your brush to help that paint flow through. I'm almost done this step. I'm going to add a few more details, more black to this tree trunk to define it some more. And then I'm going to pick up a little bit of gold and a little bit of white and come in between these trees just a little bit. Just a pull and a flick. And I've washed my liner brush off, switched over to my mini fan brush. I'm going to pull in gold and black, turning and loading both sides evenly. And I'm gonna start adding some more branches with this brush now. So we have different types of trees and branches, giving our forest painting more interest. It's not gonna be all the same. We're not gonna use all the same brushes. We're gonna use a filbert brush, the mop brush that we used already, and this fan brush, as well as the liner brush for our little branches. Okay, with my little fan brush again, I'm going to take a bit more of that gold. I've got a little bit of black left in my brush, and I'm going to tap in for some little subtle highlights here in the foreground. I'm not going to add too many details like normally I would paint little mushrooms or ferns or flowers, but in this case, it's going to take away too much from my focal point, and our focal point is where these trees are pulling our attention and drawing our eyes up into the sky. So I'll just do a little bit of that. And finish some more little branches up here, and then we'll get ready to add some color. Now you really want to make sure that your painting is completely dry before you begin your colors. So I speeded it up and I dried my painting off with a hair dryer. That works really well. Just make sure that you hold the hair dryer a few feet away from your canvas. You don't want the canvas to get too hot. It will change the color of your painting and could possibly damage your canvas. I'm switching over to my filbert brush now, and I'm going to add a few little branches and bits of foliage with this just to change the look up a little bit. Now, if you'd like to add a few little leaves or ferns and something more here in the foreground, you can. You just take a filbert brush, use the very tip of it here, and tap with some color that's going to show up on our palette. So the gold with a little bit of white will work nice. It'll be easier to do this if the black is dried first, but I'm not going to do too much in the foreground. Like I mentioned before, I want the main focus to be on the direction those trees are leaning towards in the sky. Okay, I've washed my filbert brush out really well. I want to make sure that I have no black no hint of gold in there, and I want to use straight white now. And I've got a thick amount on the tip of my brush, as you can see, and I'm just going to tap lightly where I want my sun to be the brightest, right in the center here, and just a little bit on either side. Okay, I'm gonna add a few more things here, light and shadow in the foreground, and make it look like maybe there's some rocks back there. Once I'm done this, I'll wash my brush out and I'm gonna dry my painting off completely. Now that my painting is dry, I'm gonna squeeze out my colors, neon orange and cadmium yellow. I recommend using the neon orange in this case because it really gives a beautiful glow to this painting. I'm going to blend a bit of white, yellow, and orange, and add a thin layer here and there wherever I want my color to be. You can overlap it on top of that gold and black now that it's dry. So in some areas you can use a little bit more orange and others you can use a little bit more yellow. With the cadmium yellow I'm using, if I don't have it mixed with a little bit of white or orange, it will tend to look sort of green with the black, and I don't really want this painting to look green. I just want to keep with those nice warm tones. So that's just something to think about. You can change your yellow. You can go for more of a sunflower yellow, more of an orangey yellow, or just keep blending it with the orange to prevent it from having that green tone to it. So this is looking so, so pretty. I'm really seeing where the light from the sun is popping out now, and we're creating that illusion of kind of just laying down in the forest and looking up, and what a mood it creates. This is just such a fun one. I'm loving painting this and I'm so happy I'm getting to share it with you guys. Leave a comment below and let me know what you guys think of this one. And if you have any questions, head over to my Patreon page. And I just did a Q&A over on there too. So it's about 20 minutes, uncut and unedited, and I'm answering all of your questions and then some. So there's some really interesting things over on my Patreon page, and I recommend becoming a patron today, guys. And now I've got more of my cadmium yellow. I'm going through it quite a bit today, actually. And I'm gonna blend some more with that orange, and I'm gonna just keep building this color up, creating all those soft tones with a little bit more white where I wanna have a softer glow. I'm leaving the white that I put in the center for the sun. I'm not going to go over that. I'll get very close to it, but I'm going to leave that the brightest part of this painting. Now I'm going to mix a little bit of the neon orange with black to make a brownish color and warm up this black like I mentioned earlier. I was going to go over top of it and slightly and a little bit around on the edges. Add a little bit at the top right. And I'm gonna clean my brush out and go back to this orange and start adding some more color over here, making it look a little bit richer. And then I'm gonna scumble a little bit of it off because it's a bit too intense and it's ruining the whole vibe I'm trying to go for in this painting. So it's really easy to do that with acrylic paint. And especially if your paint is still wet, you can easily just kind of scumble that off. And another way to make that orange look a bit softer is come in with my black and define some of these branches a little bit more and the tree trunks. Now originally this painting was going to be only gold and black with a little bit of orange. And then I did what I always tend to do. I get off track and I decided to pick up a little bit of my light ultramarine blue and add some of that, and I'm really glad that I did because I Love the way it ended up looking. Of course, the light ultramarine blue is very complementary to the peachy orange glow that we have in this painting. So if you guys ever do that yourselves, kind of have an idea, well, what if I tried this or what if I added some of that, but you're scared to, don't be scared. It's your conscience kind of guiding you and telling you how you can improve on your painting skills and the direction you need to take your painting in. So kind of just trust your gut and listen to those ideas that kind of pop into your head. I always do, and it's, you know, it's such a growing experience for an artist. We need to try new things. We need to listen to the ideas we have and go for it and not be afraid to try, because it's when we do that that we move forward and we grow as artists. So here I am adding that light ultramarine blue now, and you'll see how pretty it looks with the blue. I'm going to take a bit of it and go over top of part of my tree trunks, not every single one, and I'm going to tap into the foreground a bit. So it's nice for a shadow color. It also gives that kind of a look that you get early in the morning in the forest when the fog is kind of starting to lift. You get like a soft glowy haze. So you see how pretty that is? It almost has ultramarine blue has a kind of a purple tone to it. And depending on what colors you're combining it with in your painting, the orange will kind of make it have more of a purple look to it. And in this case, it works really, really well. And I'm glad I decided to do it. Of course, you guys don't. If you prefer to have it just black, you can leave it black. It looks nice too. But I love color, and this combination is a really fun one. Now, another thing that I wanted to do was add the blue and the orange together and use that tone in the painting. So I took a little bit of white, a little bit of gold first, a little bit of orange. I'm going to mix up these colors, and I'm just going to pull very lightly a few little sun rays. I can't resist. I'll just do a couple of these. And then I'm going to mix up the little bit of orange and blue together with a bit of white. And it kind of gives you a mauve look. So you'll get like a lilac-y mauve kind of a color that's really pretty. And then I'm back to the blue here, just going to soften off this tree trunk a little bit and get it, get all these little edges on the tops of the canvas so it looks really finished off. Another thing I do when I'm finished my paintings, I always paint the sides. It's something that looks really nice. It finishes off your painting, and you can just hang it on the wall like that. I never frame my paintings. I like the way they look just like this. Gives it kind of a modern, sleek look. And you can paint the sides of your canvas any color you want. Don't think that they have to be just white or just black. Black always looks nice, but sometimes I'll do like a cadmium red. I will do dark purple. Anyways, this is all done. I want to thank you guys so much for watching. I wish you happy painting. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe to my channel for more. I'll see you next time in my video very soon. Bye!